Morning student, in the previous video we discuss about the rational number. Now in this video we discuss about irrational number. What is irrational number? The square roots, cube roots of a natural number are irrational number if their exact value can be obtained. Exact value means the square root of 4, the value of square root of 4 is equal to, it is the exact value, but square root of 2, square root of 3, square root of 5, we cannot got the exact value of square root 2 and square root 3 and cube root of 5. So that's why root 2, root 3, root 5 and cube root of 5, cube root of 6 all are the irrational number. But square root of 4 is an rational number because square root of 4 we can get the exact value. Understand? Now the second definition of irrational number is a non-terminating and non-recurring decimal is an irrational number. Non-terminating means the 0.424345 and so on endlessly. It is not completely answer. And the 3.862045 and so on. So that's why both the example are non-terminating and non-recurring decimal. That's why it is an irrational number. Now pi is also an irrational number. Why? Because the value of pi is 3.145926 and endlessly. It is not a complete answer. Means it is endlessly. It is not a terminating decimal. That's why pi is an irrational number. Okay? Understand? Okay student, now we prove that root 2 is an irrational number. We have to prove that root 2 is an irrational number. So, to prove that root 2 is an irrational number, we prove its opposite that root 2 is an rational number. Okay, what is the definition of rational number? A rational number that can be represented in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q belongs to Z, Z means integer, and Q is not equal to 0. It is the definition of rational number. And another definition is P and Q have only one common factor, that is 1. It means if we take one example like 2 upon 3. So 2 and 3 have only one common factor, that is unity, 1. So root 2 is equal P upon Q. It means rational number. Now square both sides. So root 2 square is equal p square upon q square. So root 2 square means 2 p square upon q square. Now cross multiplication. So p square is equal 2 q square. Okay, it is the equation number 1. Now 2 q square is divisible by 2. 2 q square is divisible by 2. Let's check. 2q square is divisible by 2 because it gets the answer q square. That means q square is divisible by 2. And 2q square is equal to what? P square. That means p square is also divisible by 2 because equal sign here. Now, if p square is divisible by 2, then p is also divisible by 2. We can take one example. If 2 square is divisible by 2, suppose 2 square means 4, then its base is also divisible by 2. If 2 square is divisible by 2, 2 square means 4, 2 2 is 4. So its base means this is the base. So its base is also divisible by 2. 2 1 is 2. So we can use this theorem in this question. So p square is divisible by 2. That means its base, that is p, is also divisible by 2. This is the equation number 2. Understand? Now, let p is equal to 2k, any variable, p is equal to 2k. Now, put the value of p is equal to 2k in the equation number 1, that is p square is equal to 2k square. So, put the value of p is equal to 2k, now square both sides. So, 4k square is equal to 2q square. Now, 2 2s are 4. So, q square is equal to 2k square. Q square is equal 2k square. That is the equation number 3. Again, 2k square is divisible by 2. Same process. Like 2k square is divisible by 2. So we can also take 2k square is divisible by 2. It is completely divisible. That's why 2k square is divisible by 2. So it is equal to q square. So that means q square is also divisible by 2. Now, if q square is divisible by 2, then its base q is also divisible by 2. Same, like p square is divisible by 2, then p is also divisible by 2 in this method. So q square is divisible by 2, then q is also divisible by 2. That means from equation number 2, means p is also divisible by 2, and 4, that is q is also divisible by 2. From equation 2 and 4, p and q both divisible by 2. But this is contradictory. Why? Because we assume that p and q have only one common factor, that is 1. This is the definition of rational number. It means p and q have only one common factor. But we prove that p and q have a common factor, that is 2. So this is contradictory. So our assumption is wrong. It means p and q have... We prove that P and Q have a common factor 2, but this is contradictory. So our assumption is wrong. So root 2 is not a rational, it is an irrational number. Understand? Root 2 is not a rational, it is an irrational number. Now, like root 2, you can prove root 3, root 5, root 7 in the same process. So in your homework, you have to solve root 3, root 5, root 7, okay? So you can easily understand this topic clearly, okay? Thank you.